I'll be addressing us today on a very potent, very, very instructive topic. I've titled it, Life is War. Life is War. Let's turn our Bible to Deuteronomy 34, 31, verse 8. He will never leave you or forsake you. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. We flip immediately to Psalm 18, 2. Psalm 18, 2. It goes, quote, the Lord is my rock, fortress and my deliverer. The last reading for today, Romans 8, verse 28. I have to be fast because of time. Romans 8, verse 28. He goes, and we know that in all things, God works for the good of those who love him and who have been called according to his purpose. I decided to pick this because of so many things that are happening in the world. Let's look at life journey. Every man and woman on earth came through the woman. Every man, every living person came to a woman. How did he or she come? Biology, sorry, we have to go into biology. Some figures have to be mentioned. Before somebody conceives, there must have been a copulation, intimacy. This intimacy will result, of course, when you are married, spouse and all that, will result to, permit me to use the word ejaculation, but what to say is biology. For every semen that enters the woman, is about 100 million spermatozoa, sperm cells, 100 million, that is statistics. But out of this 100 million, only one will survive. Enter the fallopian tube. Only one. That means the whole rest, 99.9 will be wasted. So that's where the struggle starts. Why I'm trying to say this, because nobody is on earth by accident. Everybody that is in the, that is here in the face of this earth has a purpose. Life is war. So when the sperm cell, the one that God has planted that would germinate, as it were, copulate, it will now manifest into the womb and start growing. That's another stage of war. Some are aborted, some, the ones that are not aborted are delivered. The very first day, the very first minute, second, the baby comes out, what happens? He or she will start crying. I've been trying to unravel the mystery behind that. Why should a baby start crying? A baby that did not know anything about the earth before she came or he came, start crying. That sends the word that life is war. Not only that, as he or she goes to primary school, of course, elementary school, primary school, if he or she has the money, if her parents have the money, have the money, and she has a brain or he has a brain, she will go to university, and from there the suffering continues. Issue of school fees and all that will come. Marriage, we know, like I tweeted last week, is the only official window through which children come. So he or she will finish university, as it were, and attacks start coming. The Bible tells us that human hearts are desperately wicked. Whether you like it or not, trouble will come your way. It doesn't knock. Troubles don't knock before they come. And sorry, if you're not fortified, you won't make it. So, right from day one, your parents will start praying for you, and that's why it's imperative for parents to pray for their children. Some take it for granted. Nothing good happens by accident. The devil is there, you know, to do three things: to steal our joy, kill our joy, and of course destroy our joy. But it's not your portion from Jesus. Life itself, like I said, is full of war. No wonder Paul said, "You have fought the good fight of faith." No wonder it's written that right from the day of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God was by an environment taken by force. You graduate, you start having problems, as it were, if you are not fortified. Problem of getting a good job, problem of barrenness if you are married, all kinds of things. If you're not married and your parents will be on your neck to get married, whether you're a boy or girl, it is immaterial. You start counting, you're quitting with others. All throughout life, problem. But guess what? There's hope. Hope is there for us in the person of Jesus Christ. What do I mean by this? He came to destroy the kingdom of darkness, to destroy the works of Satan. Whether we like it or not, devil exists. And of course, our Lord Jesus Christ is Lord and life. Amen. How do we approach life? Since you already know that it's turmoil, full of acrimony, full of backbiting, people trying to undermine you for whatever reason, they'll build their houses, plotting evil, and all that. You have to wear the full armor of Christ. That is only saving grace. If you wear the armor of Christ, they will marshal you out. Heaven's arsenals will be used in your favor. You can't survive the atrocities, the wickedness of men, if you don't cover yourself. That's why I keep on illustrating. You need covering. I remind us that the smallest ant that was covered by way of entering Noah's ark became much more powerful, much more recognized than the elephant that did not, because the elephant had no covering and he perished. That is not the portion of Jesus. You need Holy Spirit to guide you to enforce seven. Remember, we were told by Lord Jesus Christ that it was imperative he goes so that he can send another helper in the person of the Holy Spirit. And of course, Holy Spirit came and destroyed the work of Satan in favor of us. Remember the upper room, the day the Pentecost had fully come. That was the day the Holy Spirit arrived and announced his arrival through their truth. You can imagine. Without Holy Spirit, you are doomed. It's not your portion of Jesus. What I'm trying to bring out here is you need Christ to navigate through the troubled waters of this land. Everywhere on earth, no place is safe. But with Christ, who has paid the price 2,000 years ago, you are covered. That is your portion of Jesus. And I decree and declare that no weapon fashioned against any of us will prosper. And any tongue that rises against us, we condemn in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We are dangerous species to the kingdom of darkness. Whether we like it or not, they will exist and they will keep on attacking. But fear him, no. He can destroy the body, but he can destroy the body and the soul. Our own, we are insured, critically insured against all the vigors, all the nonsense things the devil can bring forth. But whether we like it or not, we are bound to have some tribulation. Don't despair. Don't fret. Put your faith in Jesus and he will save you. He's real and I'm telling you the truth. But guess what? Another potent, apart from the name of Jesus, is the blood of Jesus. Blood of Jesus is the only potent blood that is still alive. If you plead the blood of Jesus before you sleep, and when you wake up, nothing shall by any means hurt you, even if they give you poison. It don't affect you. That's it. And even if you step on a scorpion, it won't hurt you in any way. In a nutshell, how do you take this? First, you put God first in everything you do. When you wake up in the morning, you thank Him for the opportunity to be alive. It's not everybody that slept that woke up. Don't ever take things for granted. Make peace with Him, and even if you are fainting in terms of sin, He will straighten you out. And that is the apostle name of Jesus. And concluding, be bold in anything you do. Because from the Bible sessions we read, He is the Alpha and Omega. He is the creator that was not created. He can never allow things to happen to you. Why? Because all powers belong to Him. Powers on earth, in heaven, and under the earth have been given to Him. That is your portion of Jesus. By extension, whatever power that Lord Jesus Christ has, He has transferred to us. He said, greater works shall we do in His name for those who are called by Him. He's real, He's alive, and He's well. Can we sing for Him? He's alive, amen, He's alive. Jesus is alive forever, He's alive, amen. He's alive, amen, He's alive. Jesus is alive forever, He's alive, amen. Whether we like it or not, whether they like it or not, He's alive. And they can't get at any of us in the name of Jesus. Because amen. They need to go and kill Jesus the second time before they reach us, and it is not possible. I prophesy, He's well with you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now, this protection has to do with only those who are in Christ Jesus. I'm sorry, if you're not in Christ Jesus, you're not part of us. We're not talking religion here, we're talking of the person, the God of God, the Lord of Lords, who created everything that was created, nothing was created that was not created by Him. The ever-powerful God, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the I am that I am, the merciful God, the soon-coming King, He is Jesus, He is alive and well. I want us to clap for Him again. In conclusion, I don't know, we may have some people who are new here, new to the platform, that needs Christ. If you need Christ, if you have not opened your door to Christ, this is an opportunity for you to do so. Don't take for granted. Remember, God has given three things from us. When we are going to die, where we are going to die, and when, where, and how. I know that we are going to live life to the fullness of time and make heaven at last time. Heaven at last. But don't take for granted anything can happen, because you are seeing three things, like I said, where, how, and when are going to pass on. So if you bend down your head and say after me, if you are ready to give your life to Christ, and even if you have, you can join them and let's say it together. In the name of Jesus. Say after me. In the mighty name of Jesus. I come to you as a sinner. Please forgive me my sins. I profess that you are my God. You came and died for my sake. And on the third day, you rose from the dead. With my sin wiped. You suffered all tribulation because of my sins. I submit to your Lordship. Please, by you, accept me back. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. If you said that with your mouth, and of course believe in your heart of what you said, I accommodate you, because your life will never be the same again. Very short prayer, but it's very potent, because He is Lord and He will continue to be God. In Jesus' name. Now we've cleansed ourselves of filthiness, let's go to the next stage. It is the will of God that we live healthy, perfectly, and permanently. Devil afflicts people with all kinds of sin, all kinds of diseases, but it's not approaching the name of Jesus. But by the stripes of our Lord Jesus Christ, we'll be made whole. So nothing shall by any means hurt us in the name of Jesus. I want, if there's anybody amongst us that has any ailment, to say it, and Jesus Christ will heal him or her in the name of Jesus. We have a few minutes for that. Jesus is still in the healing ministry. He desires that all of us be healed in Jesus' name. In any case, say it after me. or you can say amen as I pronounce this. In the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, I cause every sickness in their body, in our bodies, to disappear in the name of Jesus. I cause every sickness, whatever name you are called, to bow in the name of Jesus. I cause every sickness to bow in the name of Jesus. And I send you to the abyss of fire in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare that you are made whole in the name of Jesus. Whatever paralysis, whatever sickness, whatever name is called, I cast it out in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare, whatever stagnation that is holding you bound, I lose you in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare, in the mighty name of Jesus, all conditional causes, everything that is not of God in you, you may get out of you in the name of Jesus. It is real. I anoint you with fresh fortune to function. You will never move backwardness in the name of Jesus. Go to those looking for papers, I pray in the name of Jesus, legitimately will be given. For those looking for admission, looking for a job, I pray in the name of Jesus, they will offer you such in the name of Jesus. You will shine from glory to glory. Lord Jesus will continue to be your protector and guide in the name of Jesus. You can never be led astray in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you very much.